Hi everyone, welcome back to Sesame and Puff. Today we'll continue on FIP, and if you haven't checked our previous video on FIP introduction, please go and watch it right now. This video will be on how would your vet make the diagnosis. One important thing to note, in this video, I will try to walk you through the tests that your vet may do, but not every vet will do the exact same thing, so this is more like the general outline for the procedure. It is just to give you an idea of what to expect. Blood work. For a cat with FIP, there will be low albumin, a kind of protein, and low red blood cell count, which is anemia. There will be high globulin, which is another kind of protein, and high white blood cell count. You will also see high bilirubin, and that is a cause for jaundice seen in an FIP cat with very yellow gums and urine. Most FIP cats will have non-regenerative anemia as well as a persistent fever. If a cat is negative for FIV or FELV, then we'll go for a feline coronavirus test. While we can measure the amount of coronavirus antibodies produced by the cat, the test cannot definitively distinguish between feline coronavirus and feline infectious peritonitis virus, which is basically just feline coronavirus with one or more genetic mutations. The test can only tell for sure that there is feline coronavirus, but whether it is the original form, the feline coronavirus, or the mutated fatal form, FIP virus, we do not know. However, in spite of this limitation, young cats with fever that is not responsive to antibiotics and have high coronavirus titers are often presumptively diagnosed with FIP, appropriately in most cases. This is particularly true if a yellow fluid with many protein and white blood cells begin to accumulate within the body cavities. A healthy cat with many antibodies against coronavirus, however, is not necessarily more likely to develop FIP or be a carrier of the FIP virus than a cat with low antibody count. In cats with suppressed immune systems, FIP virus infections may not produce much coronavirus antibodies. We may also use PCR. Your vet will draw a sample of the fluid for testing, most likely from the abdomen. A positive RT-PCR on the fluid is a confirmed diagnosis of FIP. A negative RT-PCR on the fluid does not necessarily rule out FIP, since there is a 30% chance of the result being false negative. RT-PCR tests will not run on blood or feces, or else there will be a higher chance of getting false results. Ultrasound. Dry FIP may cause lesions on different affected organs. An ultrasound can reveal whether or not lesions are present and check for enlarged mesenteric lymph nodes and enlarged kidneys. During the ultrasound, a fine needle aspiration of the lesions may be done and samples can be sent to a lab for immunostaining. There are also other tests, the immunoperoxidase test and the immunofluorescence test. These tests are to detect the viral proteins in the virus-infected white blood cells in the tissue or the body fluids.
So that's it for today. For the next video, we'll talk about the latest possible treatment for FIP and how you might actually prevent it in the first place. So please subscribe to our channel and stay tuned. And we'll see you in a week's time. Bye!